Hey guys, welcome back to another episode of Lucy the Eternity Shoes Far. I enter the house. I don't hear anyone, but I see my father's shoes. Could he be taking a nap? It'd be a blessing if we didn't run into each other again. Carefully, without making any sound, I enter my room. Lucy, you make sure you stay quiet too. Achievement unlocked. Dream of electric sheep. What? This has gotta mean something. October 30th. Oh yeah, the other episode, alright everyone, it was October 12th when the game started. I looked at my first episode. Or something. I looked at something that said that. But I think I restarted the game. Yeah, I restarted the game. It starts October 12th, so September 29th and the other time, that's like 2 weeks. 2 weeks until I actually found Lucy. But let's see what happens now. Hopefully I'm not getting too close to the end of the game, because I want this to last a little bit longer. What's that noise? Humming. She's humming. Lucy is cleaning her room. She appears to be in a good mood today. The room isn't very messy, but that's only because Lucy has been working diligently. Yeah, and even though the room isn't messy, Lucy continues to clean as usual. It's already become a part of her daily routine. Without allowing a single speck of dust to fall onto the floor, Lucy proceeds with clinical efficiency. Such a great angel. She's so cute. Lucy glides across the floor with a vacuum cleaner. She does it each and every corner and organizes the pile of books on the desk. She hangs up the jackets inside the closet and places the folded underwear inside various drawers, which she increases process. Not too long after, she finally stretches her back. Why would she need to do that? She's an android. Then she wipes her forehead with the back of her hand. Oh wait, Aunt Lucy become human! Yeah, the way she massages her waist while letting out deep breaths is no doubt the appearance of a typical woman. She stares at the sky throughout a window. Do you even know that I'm watching you this whole time? It'd been a while since you've seen such warm, sunny weather. Well, yeah, it's because it's like November, or almost November. Compared to the chilly weather she's been seeing lately, this was quite rare. I just realized tomorrow in this game is Halloween. The sunlight is faintly shining down from the sky. Hopefully it'll stay this warm. I wonder if Halloween's going to play any part in this, or if it's just going to be another day. That'd be nice, Lucy. Usually it'll probably... If South Korea is anything like America, especially Midwest or Illinois, where I'm at, then it'll be like November... It'll start snowing in November, late November, and it'll snow up until April. Fuck, like last year. Well, it's almost time for her master to return home from school. Like, global warming, where'd you go? She makes her way towards the living room to finish up the rest of her chores. Imagine how bad it is in this time, though. 2038, 2050, that 2038 Detroit become human. No, please. When Lucy arrived in the living room, she tilted her head in confusion. It was because she had heard something. Its father says, "Oh no! Not another one of these scenes! Come on!" She can't make out what he's saying, but he's speaking quite loudly. It doesn't seem like he's just talking to himself. Soon enough, Lucy hears the voice of another person. The mother! It's a woman. Oh no. It's the mother. The stepmother. With a careful step, Lucy makes her way towards his room. But she suddenly stops to think. She's reminded of her father's frightening demeanor. She might get scolded again if she runs to him. Feeling a little scared, Lucy stops at the base of the door. From there, she cautiously peers into the room. No, don't even bother. Oh, so that's it. She sees father, but does he see her? He's talking to a lady that Lucy's unfamiliar with. She looks like she's in her early 30s. Lucy quietly mutters to herself. Is it just basically... Is my character not even around right now, and he's just narrating what she's doing? Be careful not to get caught. She listens in. Being careful not to get caught, she listens in while keeping her distance. Why are you narrating what she's doing if you're not even in this situation? What? Her sensitive ears began to pick up their voices clearly. I played everything on the robot. Nothing's been going well ever since that thing came along. No, don't talk about me, because clearly I'm the robot. Beep boop boop, beep boop. No, Lucy knows that eavesdropping is bad, but overcome by her curiosity, she continues to listen. My son has started acting strange. He's become a fucking weeb. He was never like this before. Are you sure? I've always felt that he was a rebellious type. Yes, I'm sure. He might have been a little bit on the quiet side, but he still used to be a good kid. Well, if you say so, dear. Master stepmother. Lucy came to that conclusion from the way that the woman was talking to the father. She had heard once from Master that father remained with the young secretary, but it seems that she doesn't stop by this place very often. Yeah, it's narrating for Lucy. What about me? I've been thinking something was up, but I never thought that his condition would be so severe. Condition? He's completely out of it. You act like I have some sort of disease or something now. To think that he's confusing a robot with a human being. that's just like what's been on the news lately. Tisk tisk, how could a young boy like him lack such common sense? Oh, she doesn't like that either? Confusing a machine with a person. Hey! Sometimes androids are more human than humans are, especially in Detroit Become Human. Lucy, become human! Lucy, become human! It's eerily realistic. It's far better at copying people than other models. I've seen that sly contraception laugh and cry. Didn't you say once that she has quite the looks, too? Mm-hmm. Since she's just like a person and listens to his every command. Just like a normal woman! Oh! Just kidding. I can see how it could be a problematic for a boy his age. But still, she's just a robot. Perhaps he's having trouble at school? Trouble. Trouble, trouble. Don't they say this often? That unsociable children are usually the ones that get attached to androids. Since they have trouble getting along with people, they grow close with androids instead. Robots are always willing to listen to them, unlike people. It's clear that he's having trouble with his school life. I wouldn't know, since he rarely ever talks about what happened in school. I wonder why! Anyway, it's certain that the robot is the cause of all these problems. Not school! Not school, no. There's no doubt. But I don't know what I'm supposed to do. Isn't it obvious? No. What do you mean? Why don't you just go destroy it? You stupid bitch! I don't like stepmom! What? Go dispose of it. The robot's the reason behind all this, right? Is he actually going to defend? Say, you know, I'm not going to do that. Is she even worse than him? Her words are followed by a moment of silence. But then he'll be really upset about it. Isn't it just like a toy anyway? When his condition improves, we can always buy him a new one. But then I'll be the same way again. It's not as simple as that. The robot looked a bit special. Then are you planning to leave things the way they are? You think his feelings are more important than his future? Oh my god. Something must be done about this, right? Yeah. Then just get rid of it. Go smash it in pieces or set it on fire or whatever. Oh my god, just like Detroit Become Human. No. Father appeared to be rolling it over. You're right. That robot is the cause of all this. He was doubting it for a second. That's a sign. If that robot disappears, if that robot gets out of our way, everything will soon return to normal. He wasn't gonna do it though, He considered his feelings, his son's feelings. Progress. Oh, Lucy, you heard all that. Get away from the door before they see you. That was as far as Lucy could listen. She couldn't bring herself to stay any longer. You know, maybe after she walked away, maybe he changed his mind again. She started to walk away from them, looking sullen. Correction, she tried to get away. Ow. While scrambling to leave, Lucy bumped into a nearby display. Now you're really gonna get broken. Just like you broke that. She managed to catch it just in time to prevent it. Okay, good. But she made a lot of noise in the process. Who's there? No, no, no. Father and woman rushed out of the room. Oh, by the way, you can probably see my mouse now. I had it set to you can do that. That would have been very helpful in one of my recent Doki Doki videos when Monica was controlling the mouse. But oh well, I'm sorry. I thought, I didn't, for some reason I thought this screen record I was using couldn't do that. But I had set it to where it wouldn't do that. I'm like, oh. Please, don't destroy it. It's you. Were you listening? This makes an excuse for putting the jar back in this place.
저기, 죄송합니다.
Don't admit it.
일부러 엿듣고 있었던 건 아니고요.
That's enough. It makes everything a lot easier then. I ordered you to leave this house. Oh. We have no use for you. There's nothing we need from you in this household. So he doesn't want to break her, he just wants her to leave.
So please. 하지만 주인님께서는...
My son doesn't need you either. He's only confused because he's young. You're not being of any help to my son. You're only causing him to suffer. So run along. Forever disappear from our sights. No, Lucy, don't.
Lucy는...
Lucy stood in timid posture, but her voice was as firm as ever. Am I not going to do anything about this? Come on. Am I asleep or what?
Lucy는 그렇게 생각 안 해요.
Well, in fact, I don't agree with you. What?
Lucy는 분명 주인님의 도움이 되고 있다고 생각해요.
In the past, she wouldn't have been able to say for sure, but now it's different. She continues to speak with great confidence.
주인님께서 말씀해 주셨어요. 루시가 필요하다고 말해 주셨어요. 그러니까 루시는 나가고 싶지 않아요.
Yeah, I want you to stay, Lucy.
앞으로도 계속
you should probably leave,
주인님의
come back
도움이
later.
되고 싶어요.
All right. It doesn't seem like we'll get anywhere by talking. Oh, no, never mind. He's gonna do something about it. My father disappears like something. A moment later, he returns with a container filled with gasoline in his hand. Are you seriously gonna light her on fire? He pours the gasoline onto Lucy. Gasoline makes a loud splash as it makes contact with Lucy. She soon becomes drenched from top to bottom. I can't tell. Maybe I can see a little bit. Lucy stands silent. Gasoline covering her body. No! Father takes out a lighter and flicks it on. He holds the light out, threateningly close. This is my last warning. Leave if you do not wish to be turned into a pile of ashes. And don't you dare come back. Stay out of my son's life forever. Lucy silently deserts her slimy body. Become human! Become a deviant! Take that thing off of your ear. Kick his ass. What should Lucy do? Lucy tries asking herself. But there isn't anyone that could give her an answer. Without knowing what to do, Lucy remains standing still for quite a long time. Her body is designed to be able to withstand intense heat for a short while, but it won't be long before she begins to melt. Lucy suddenly remembers Master's order. Run away if she's in danger. That was the order. Yeah, Lucy, just go and come back later. Or just come get me. Where the hell am I? Am I at school or what? She didn't know what to do, but she decided to leave the scene first. Staying here would be going against the second anti law of robotics. In order to prevent that, Lucy begins to move. Please take care. Get all that grease off of you. But instead, Lucy leaves. Don't even think about showing up here. Don't talk to me or my son ever again. If you do, you'd better be prepared to pay the price. I'm in no way exaggerating. Keep that in mind. Stupid stepmom, you was gonna keep her. Or you at least wasn't gonna do anything rash about it. Maybe. All Lucy did was give the ground a lonely stare. Did she really have to part with Master like this? With a heavy heart, she made her way outside, leaving behind a slimy trail of gasoline. Father, you could have just threatened her with gasoline first and not just get her. Father followed after to make sure she left. Am I at school? Once outside, Lucy found herself staring at the sky absentmindedly. It was bright and sunny out, which had been a rare sight in the recent weeks. Lucy stopped in her tracks momentarily as she stared into the sky. Then she smiled brightly. It was a refreshing smile, free of care of all cares in the world. It sure is a lovely day today. Thought it would be a good weather to go for a picnic. Why is it irritating for her? Come on now. Oh, it glitched. Oh my god, is she deviating? I know this isn't the Detroit Become, but I'm sure it's something similar is possible. That was a glitch. I had to have been at school during all this. But I had to do that to show that scene. Oh. Yeah. Okay. No, you can't hang up there. That says... Sorry I didn't read that, I just want to hurry up. Feels like I've been getting home a lot earlier lately, and it really is true. I've started going straight home after school. In the past, I've aimlessly wandered the streets passing time. But I can no longer do that, because there's something waiting for me at home. No, there isn't. I would have never imagined in the past that this would ever happen. Who knew going home could be this exciting? Oh no. I wonder what we'll talk about today. Oh no. I wonder what kind of faces she'll make, what kind of stupid things she'll say. Oh no. I wonder what about the most pointless things. Oh no. A pointless things I was so excited to see. I enjoy chatting with her of all the dumbest things. How much do I enjoy it? Well, it feels as if my life had been purposely so dull and boring up at this point in order to make up for my faded meeting with Lucy. To the point where I begin to have silly thoughts like these. That's how much I enjoy it. Even I think that sounds corny, but it can't be helped. It's too late now because emotions are not something anyone can easily control. I decided to pick up my pace, just so I'd be able to meet Lucy a little bit faster. But she's not there anymore. Oh no. It was when I'd almost arrived home that I began to feel something terrible was about to happen. Staggering air is kind of foreshadowing that something terrible is about to happen. I didn't understand why, but I could feel it in the air. Something ominous.
In your book,
I couldn't my pace anymore. I was practically running. Oh no, something's bad. Oh no. Am I gonna run away too now? What? I couldn't believe what was happening before my eyes. I felt my knees giving way. What kind of sick joke is this? My mouth hung open, wide open, refused to close. But she left. Lucy. Lucy was on fire. Man, she's so hot, am I right? Her entire body was burning up, in a place where she always used to stand while waiting for my return. While engulfed in flame, she was staring at me. My head went blank. I could not process what was happening at all. How'd this happen? Lucy? I didn't feel like the Lucy in front of me was real. I felt as if I was dreaming. I laid a hand on top of Lucy. Ow. It was hot. It was hotter than she normally is. Scorching hot. The pain helped me return to my senses. I charged inside the house. My father is standing in the way, trying to speak to me. I cannot comprehend what he's saying. I push him aside into the house. Get out of my way! I scream. Get out of my way! Out of my way. Ruthless, you know I could be just like you. That's funny how that's Today's Grace song is playing, and it's... I could be sexless. I could be just like you. Because he was just like the father, but now he's not. While running wild like a maniac, I scream at the top of my lungs. I prance around the house in a crazed fit. Grab water! My vision is turning blurry because of all the tears. Only then I finally realize that I'm crying. The tears are making it difficult to see where I'm going. Get water! I head towards the living room and attempt to locate the fight. That works better. Yes. Don't you dare stop me. If he gets in my way, hit him with the fire extinguisher. There it is. After finding the fire extinguisher, I run as hard as I could with it. I'm in such a hurry that I sloppily fall over with a butt crash. That doesn't matter. My knees seem to be bruised, but it doesn't matter. Who cares? Without any delay, I get right back up and continue running. Father, you better not get in my way. I'll beat the shit out of you with this fire hydrant. I yank out the safety pin and aim at the hose at Lucy and release the payload. Faster. Go, faster. Gotta go faster. Come on, faster. Praying that the fire will be out just a little bit faster. I continue to spray. Keep spraying. Just keep doing it. Come on, Lucy. I gotta save my Lucy. After a short while, the fire vanishes like magic. But... But the Lucy revealed beneath the fire didn't look too good. I feel like... She doesn't look too good. Oh no. After this video records, I'm gonna make a different intro, because this is gonna come after Monica to leave the game. Like, come to the game just to find out that this happens anyways. Well, no. So, knowing that, now I'm gonna bring that up since I haven't since then. But Lucy revealed beneath fire didn't look too good. Oh, come on! Are you kidding me? Like, I just got back to this point after, like I said at the beginning of the video, that Monica deleted the game and I had to replay all of it, but I had just come back and... Oh, no. And I did all the same things I did before. Oh, I gazed at the... It didn't look too good. It doesn't feel too good. I gazed at the various patches of her skin that were melted off. Her condition isn't as severe as I thought it would be. Most likely thanks to her fire-resistant skin. That's good. I can't see her very well due to my blurred vision, however. Gotta get the tears out. I'm not actually crying, though. As you could tell before I wiped it, there was not. As if my words could hurt her, I call out her to death delicately. There's no reply. Lucy! Her eyes are closed. There's no response coming from her at all. What are you doing? Answer me. Lucy! I anxiously wait for her to reply. I wait for her to open her mouth. Lucy! But her unrelenting lips refuse to fellicate my desires. They refuse to listen to my earnest request. Take her up to the repair shop! Come on now! Lucy, this is an order. Answer me. Answer me, damn it! Take her to the repair shop. I try to don't to anything. Her eyes caught. Okay, what? What have you done? Take her to the repair shop! Don't. I hope I take that fire extinguisher and hit the father upside the head of it. Please. Please. I turn to face my father. Are you happy now? Are you proud of yourself? I've done nothing wrong. You heard it here, folks. You've done nothing wrong. It refused to listen to me until the very end. Even though I told it many times to leave. All it did was get rid of something worthless. Why? Why'd you have to go this far? It's about time you opened your eyes. What's lying before you is not a dead person. It's just a broken down robot. Nothing more, nothing less. It's only broken machinery. If someone did this to my laptop, I would beat the shit up. I don't care if it looks like a real person. You do anything to my... anything mechanical that's expensive, I'm gonna beat the shit out of you. You can always buy another one to replace it. No, it has important stuff in it. Like, for Lucy, it's memories. It has something to get so worked up over. I feel my insides convulsing. A faint, sorrowful voice flows out of my mouth. I don't know anymore. I just don't. When we're able to do something like this... second thought. I don't know if we humans really are better than androids. Like I said, humans are worse than androids. Androids are more human than they are. I don't know what part of human nature makes us better than Lucy. I just don't know anymore. Is he saying this to the father? Take Lucy to the repair shop. Like, people take pride in being human. Is this like the end or something? People take pride in being human, and people do not want to lose their power to govern the world. That's why they fear robots, avoid robots, show contempt for robots, and eventually do something like this without batting an eyelash. Can we say for sure that we compared this android lying to the ground compared to Lucy? Are we humans truly ever more deserving to exist on this planet? Exactly. I wasn't so sure anymore. Androids are going to be the ones to change the world, just like Hank said. Lucy! Then I suddenly heard a voice. It was Lucy's voice, honestly. I'd give everything to hear you say Chun-Li again. Even though it kind of annoyed me a little bit. I'm so hungry and this food's gonna get... Lucy! She sounded strained as if her light was about to flicker out any second. Please, no. Her body was damaged to the point that it was almost painful to look at. But she still retained her usual voice that I had been longing for. Her eyes were firmly locked onto my face. You! Are you alright? Don't lie to me, Lucy. Her voice is quivering uncontrollably. Her body is almost making a lot of strange crackling noises. She doesn't look all right at all. She looks like she's about to seize up any moment. And yet, despite such hindrance, she was trying hard. She was trying hard to say something.
아버님 탓이 아니에요.
Yes, it is. She's in such a pitiful state that she spoke so calmly. She sounded like she was trying to make her best make me feel at ease. Her solid composure made my chest tighten. What are you talking about? Oh, is that why it glitched earlier? Yeah, because you...
명명해 스스로를 위험을
yeah.
이곳에 그러니까 루시가
No, it's his fault for wanting to get rid of you in the beginning. It's not... It's like that with the freaking deviants. They blame them for the humans being assholes to the androids. And the unescapable chains humans have bestowed on robots. Is she trying to say that she's in this only because she broke the laws? Is she trying to say that the fire had nothing to do with it? I feel a sudden surge of anger welling up inside me. You idiot! What did I tell you? Run away! I told you to run away if something ever happens to you. I thought I made that very clear. I even ordered you to. Why didn't you listen? Why didn't you listen and let yourself get hurt? Exactly. After hearing those words, Lucy tried to smile. She tried her hardest to smile. Her voice was so faint that I couldn't make out what she was saying. What?
Yeah. 약속했으니까. 언제나 마중 나가겠다고 매일매일 집 앞에서 그렇게
You could have came to the school and saw me.
그러니까 여기 남아서 웃는 얼굴로 주인님을 기뻐하는
Yeah, but obviously there's conflicting orders. You could have Obviously, this is not how this would happen. Yeah, that was just a prompt. You didn't have to wait for me. I told you that wasn't in order. You could have just ignored it. A weak smile forms on her face. Then you'd be fine. No, I wouldn't. We're gonna see it now, anyway. Seriously? Unless I get to fix up. Fix up, come on. And like that, she's kidding you about Nonsense. Nonsense is only a true robot to fathom. No, you don't. Yeah, but not like this. Yeah, but not like this. This isn't doing that, Lucy. It makes no sense, Lucy. Doesn't make any sense at all. How am I supposed to be happy after seeing like this? Her body began to convulse. I understood the implications behind such admirable movements. That she was making her final struggle. That I would never be able to hear her voice again. You can get her fixed. That she wouldn't be ever coming outside to greet me again. Or making me angry with her silliness. Her lightly compressed, caressing my forehead. The tears are blurring my vision, making it hard to sleep. Come on, get her fixed. I hastily wipe my eyes clean. I'm not crying, you are.
No,
I just got set on fire, but this is fine. It's like that one meme. 6 seconds. This is fine, yeah. I couldn't understand the meaning behind the words. What could possibly be fine? Is this really fine for you? Ending up like this, are you really okay with
that?
What's the point if you're not there, though? No. Oh, come on, say it. The attorney Lucy wished for. I understood what she was about to say. The attorney she wished for, yeah. Not in the little sense, but the true attorney that we discussed in the
past.
That one episode is foreshadowing. Am I gonna have to choose? You're being too selfish. Acting on your own like that. Even if you're fine with the whole situation. Even if you have no regrets. What am I supposed to do? Now that she's leaving me behind, what am I supposed to do? Hey, don't say that. You can get a fix. Come on. Don't lose his head. It's shaking a little. Become human. Deviate. Become human.
Oh, no.
Come on. Marcus came back from the dead. You can too. That's creepy. Her voice is gradually changing. The crystal clear voice she once had is now turning into a garbled mess. Just like when we first met. Just like back when she used to be completely useless. I can shake my head, yes or no. Lucy's fingers are twitching. Nonetheless, Lucy's fingers press on. There's a voice that might cut off at any second. She's still desperately trying to hear my answer. I have to make up my mind. I've seen her struggle, I have to make up my mind right here now. But holding back the cries swelling up inside, I give her a nod with my tears. Okay, I don't have to choose. Yeah, I will. I remember you, damn it. Yeah, nod. Lucy smiles, okay, you can tell. Lucy! Lucy. Oh no. Lucy? Get her fixed, right? That was the end of it. With that, the conversation never went on. With that, she no longer responded to my cries. The light never returned to her eyes. Mother's eyes will no longer meet my gaze. She will no longer smile. And she won't be coming back for all eternity. In the end, it was just like she wished for. I could say for sure that she will clearly be engraved in my memories. And with that, this pain will be remembered forever. I'll never be able to forget, even if I want to. And I have no choice but to remember. No matter how many mental exhaustion and degraded I become. No matter how painful it becomes. I have no choice but to remember her existence. And that's all I have left, to remember her name, Lucy Valentine. And all the unpleasant memories that come along with it. That was what she wished for. And it was something unbearably cool for me to endure. Is that it? Let there be more, please. No, not never be able to see her again. Oh no, it's just like 2010, 2012 all over again. All she can do is exist in my memories and in my dreams. Oh no. I'm not crying, you are. Oh no, Lucy. No. Lucy. I'm not crying. This chicken smells so good. It's steaming, making my eyes water. It's steaming in here. Oh no. I'm not crying. There's stuff in my eyes. Oh no, I'm eating. What? I ate when I'm upset. I mean, I'm not upset. No, I'm just hungry. I was just making a Kung Fu Panda breakfast. Don't, no. Chicken, rice, and peppers. Lucy. Victoria. Oh, is there more? Am I getting a new android? Hey. You listening? Cheer up. Did I tell them? Oh, come on, what's wrong with you? You're even making meat hurts. Am I getting a new one? This is why I warned you. Shut the... Not to get attached to so much. Shut up. Robots are robots, humans are humans. Never heard because you couldn't tell the two apart. I wonder why you crossed the line. The line that wasn't meant to be crossed. And they made it so clear for you too. I wonder if there's anything to do with the things I chose, if like maybe if I could have got a different ending. But I don't know if this is a game like that. I warned you that you'll be the only one hurt in the end. Ah, really? How foolish are you? You can barely shut your mouth away. My character might beat the shit out of you. I don't know, he doesn't seem like that type, actually. Otherwise, he probably would've... Yeah. I remain silent. I have nothing to say. But now that I think about it, maybe this turned out to be a pretty good experience for you after all. I don't think so. I raise my head up to look at him. The fact that you finally learned your lesson makes it all worth it, I think. Learning a lesson, you're funny. May have been a harsh lesson, but there wasn't there some merit to it? I wonder if this game's like saying, hey, don't get attached to video game characters. Is it trying to break the fourth wall? You should know this better than anyone else. Or is this like making fun of people who play these type of dating sims games? It's kind of be like Doki Doki Literature Club where it's like, hey, you can't get the girl you want. Well, I guess you're right. Mm-hmm. Then let us start enjoying life properly. So why are we by the robotic store, huh? What are we getting, another one? What do you mean? There are a lot more interesting things in life than androids. So let's go find out what's in store for us. Because to be honest, we've devoted a huge chunk of our lives just to study, right? It's time for us to catch up on all the fun stuff. What is this? How about you give me an example? Alright. First, we should try to get to know some girls. You sound as if you haven't been trying. That's just mean. Anyway. There are always women out there who are more attractive than Lucy. No, there's not. And, of course, women with better figures, too. She has a good figure. What are you talking about? Although, you won't be able to be dealing with a robot, so there must be someone who's as nice as Lucy. There is, but I can't remember either. Oh, there is some just like her. But I couldn't have her. Not like I was actually trying to be with Lucy or anything, but... With a woman like that, you should try getting into a serious relationship. As if real girls are going to be that good. Any other real girls besides the one I was just talking about. And go traveling to all kinds of different places together and make lots of special memories. Let's try all the fun things we missed out on. Who cares about all that? I'm happy to live the way, my life the way I wanted it to be. That's the eternity I wish for, not what you're talking about. Fuck you. Eventually you'll be able to move on from this. Nah. No, I haven't been able to move on from this from 10 years ago. How do you expect me? No, it does not. It doesn't sound like what a person with the SAT coming up in the next couple of days would say. That's true. But whatever, we're both responsible people. And on top of that, studying should not be your biggest concern right now. He gives me the poke on my chest. I tilt my head in confusion. Curing this place right here is our top priority. That's, well, thanks, but... Yeah. It might be good to go out and enjoy myself from time to time. Maybe. Yeah, you're excited too, right? No. I'm telling you, things will definitely pick up from now on. Just trust me and look forward to it. So come on, cheer up. Make me. Brush off the dust and get back up. Make me. To those words, I gave a small nod, pretending to agree. I appreciated for trying to cheer me up. At the same time, I felt apologetic. Because I didn't do it, Is Lucy gonna be fixed up? Man, you look like you've gone to hell and back. I'm sorry. About what? I couldn't keep my promise. Even though I said I'd take good care of her. Huh, and I was wondering what you were going on about. That's not something you should be apologizing to me about, is it? There's no point. Just in case there's any hope left inside of you, I'll make it clear again. Her body, her memory chips, and everything else, they were all completely destroyed in the fire. This isn't something even I can handle. I'm waving the white flag. Oh. She's a goner. Even if you went to the genius who made Lucy, you probably wouldn't be able to fix her up. I know. Why don't we try that? Alright. As long as you understand. I wouldn't be suffering so much if I never picked her up in the first place. I understand how I could be feeling so down when I live my childhood practically alone. It appears that I've changed quite a lot ever since Lucy entered my life. Same, when the one girl entered my life, oh no, you'll be able to move on someday. 20 years later, move on? Yeah, they say time heals all wounds, right? No, that doesn't. It sounds cliche, but it's true. No, it isn't. The pain you're experiencing from your loss will eventually disappear without a trace. You know it won't. Do you really think so? Yeah, no, you're wrong though. You can't possibly dwell on Lucy for the rest of your life, right? Make me. So forget about her. That's what I'll try to do. Surely I'll be able to forget about Lucy. Like, it's not Lucy that I'm... this is a metaphor. It's a metaphor. Lucy. Metaphor for someone else. Symbolic. Just like that, I left the store. I thought to myself that'd be great if things happened, as he said. After my pain had subsided, after I had put Lucy in the past, would I really be able to live on just like before? Would I really be able to live on without feeling any pain, I wonder? Oh, absolutely. No, there's plenty of things that could happen. You can't trust these hoes in real life. Why is it showing me this? What is she remembering? Is she remembering? 20 years later. Arrive at the airport in a taxi. Oh my god, how long is this game? Nope, it's the... This is the end of this episode. But I don't know how much longer this is going on. Damn. It's time to say goodbye to Korea. I have to go on a business trip to the U.S. It won't be a short one. I probably won't be coming back for a while. I remind of all the past as I glance at my surroundings. I've made so many memories here. It's my birthplace, after all. But it'll be quite a fresh experience to stepping onto a new land. Keeping track of the flight times, I board the plane heading to America. America. So this is 2070 now. Time passes while I sit, so comfortably into my chair, while no picture to go with it. An android approaches me and hands me a menu. I decide on a simple meal. After receiving my order with a smile, the robot leaves. My stare lingers on its back for a while. Image reminds me of something. Something from back in my years. I broke it down with a bot. It takes me quite a while to remember this. Are you kidding me? You don't even remember. Pathetic. Lucy Valentine, I was about to say. That was probably it. I was really quite immature back then. I can't believe I was able to cry over a little robot like that. Fuck you! At the time, I seriously felt that my world had crumbled. I suppose I was too naive. My cheeks reddened with memories about that particular incident. Well, whatever, I'm sure everyone else has at least one or two embarrassing memories of their own. Shut up! I felt foolish at the same time. Miss who I was back then. Now, that gets me thinking. I really changed since that event long ago. It's not something I can judge alone, though. Sorry if I'm talking quietly, by the way. Staring at my wife's face on my display my phone screen, I've become lost in thought. A stable job, notable social status in some society, a very large home and expensive imported vehicles, a beautiful wife and adorable, loving children. Damn! Can you show me it? Show me them? I want to see at least. Without hesitation, I could probably say that I've been living a happy, enjoyable life. If I hadn't moved on from my attachment to robots in the past, if I had stayed foolish and naive like back then, I would never have been able to obtain what I have today. I mean, you still could have kept the android around. If I'm being truly honest with myself, perhaps I do have some regrets. But what's done is done. You know exactly. What's done is done. The choices I've made define the kind of man I am now. Oh, sorry, that was probably actually on screen. I'll point that out. People change, simply change as they mature, that's reality. My eyes begin to dim. That's true, I've matured since then. For most things. Sleepover taking name over my past dates. Another once I wake, some turners have been forgotten once more, without knowing if they will ever return to me. Like I always, I will continue to look towards the future. Shut up, no, make me. It's been 10 years. since the incident, I think of that this is very forgotten memory. So is there another ending CG gallery? Cool. An old man's wish. What? Anything else? Well, that's the end. Okay, good thing I didn't start a new episode. It would have been 4 minutes. Okay, that's creepy. There's no music anymore. Oh. You know, I'll just see what this is. Oh my gosh, I'll be kidding. You know, I'm just gonna show what that is in a separate video, because I don't know how long that's last for. I don't want to record it right now. But I hope you guys enjoyed this Let's Play of Lucy and Eternity She Wished For. I'll probably, like I said, do that. And if there's any other endings, and I'll look that up and see about that. But, yeah. Sorry if I got too emotional. I'm not attached to androids or anything. It's just, it's very... I don't know why I'm gonna record for now. I'm not recording for now. I'm just needing the footage. I was thinking attached to Lucy in particular. It's just that she reminds me of somebody. And I lost somebody. They're not dead. I just can't see them anymore. And that's just what, it just reminds me of that. That's why I got a little emotional. Quote unquote. And I'm not sure if I'll ever see her again. Don't know why I still am.
He's not ready to go.
Glad I didn't go to that. Anyways. Yeah, just remind me of my past and how, yeah. As for Lucy, sure, she's waifu material, but, I'm sure 20 years from now I probably won't even remember this game or care much about it. I mean, I'm gonna play Detroit Become Human soon as a versus, but I'll talk more about that some other time, but, and I'll probably talk about this game a lot in it, but other than that, this was a fun game. I think it's really just trying to subtly hint, like, hey, if the future comes, don't get too attached to androids, or don't get attached to video game characters. Hey, it's probably poking fun at that. And don't worry, I don't get too attached to fictional characters, and because obviously they can never, nothing like this could ever happen, because they can't actually die. Because I could literally just play the game again, boom, everything's all normal. If I really wanted more Lucy. Like, I'll be fine. Like, it's not like I'm trying to play mods or anything, because Natsuki got deleted and don't get the Lyrics Club. But, if you guys enjoyed this episode of, Lucy the Eternity Wish For, you want to see anything else that I can do with this game, be sure to leave a like and a comment down below and let me know you did. And subscribe for more. See ya. I mean, happy. See ya. Oh.